the show is about to start.
Oh my god.
Serena, please welcome the audience with our Delta New greeting.
Thank you for attending Eaglecrest High School's production of Legally Blonde, the musical. We are... Pilar, are you texting right now?
Yeah, I'm telling everyone about the show.
Not now. Let's all take this time to silence our phones and store those in a safe place.
You can tell all your friends about the show during our 15-minute intermission.
Oh, and we'll have refreshments and snacks on sale at the concession booth. But you better make sure you finish those before the show starts back up, or else.
Oh my god, Serena, don't threaten them. We need to end on a happy note.
I mean, thanks so much for coming.
We hope you enjoyed the show.
Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. for a blonde.
Right, with a half-loop stitch on China silk?
Yes!
But the thing is, you can't use a half-loop stitch on China silk. It'll pucker. And you didn't just get this in because I saw it in last May's Vogue.
Oh my god, you guys.
I am not about to buy last year's dress at this year's price.
Hell saw right through the sales girl's lies.
You may be perfect for a blonde, but I'm not that blonde. I may be in love, but I'm that stupid lady. Sorry, our mistake. Courtney, take a break. Just ignore her, she hasn't been well. Try this latest from Milan. Go on, try it on.
Trailer trash here. Richard Simmons is our neighbor.
Hell.
If I want to be a senator when I'm 30, I'm gonna need somebody serious. That's about Barrett, poor Jackie. Serious. Somebody classy and not too tacky.
What?
That came out wrong. Baby, let's both be strong. I mean, we've known all along.
Just shut up. What does that mean? I'm not a Jackie. I'm not serious. I am seriously in love with you.
My future's all planned. I've got some dreams to make true. I thought that you'd understand. It's time to get serious. Time to get serious. Check, please.
Hey everybody, it's the spring fling guy! have it on. What you want to be strong?
Be strong!
Oh!
134, not good enough. Try again. Go!
What you want to be proven, bump and shake the room. What you want to be proven, something in the tone. What you want to be under where your youth is gone. What you want to hold on.
Hold on! 151, still not Harvard material. Try again.
She's a player?
Apparently.
It says here she has a 4.0 GPA.
In fashion merchandising.
And she got a 175 in her LSAT.
And she has a letter of recommendation from Oprah Winfrey!
Now, I'm not trying to argue that she's completely unqualified, but she didn't even bother to submit a personal essay.
Wow, this for a personal essay!
But I still don't see reason why we should admit you.
How about love? Have you ever been in love? Because if you have, you'll know that love never accepts a defeat. No challenge it can't meet, no place it cannot go. Don't say no to a woman in love. Don't laugh when I say love. Don't think that I'm not.
Yes.
Welcome to Harvard.
Hello, I'm Emmett Forrest, class of Op 5, represent. Welcome to the hallowed halls of Harvard Law. I know firsthand how hard you've all worked to be here today, so let's go around the room and share a bit about ourselves. Maybe if we're all and we're ready to go, we'll share a little bit about ourselves. At this point, we're not quite set. But now, we'll share a little bit about ourselves.
Aaron Schultz. I won a Fulbright and a Rhodes to become fabulously wealthy, writing financial software code. But spending all my money grew painfully insipid and stale, so now I'm here at Harvard Law.
Well, that's...
Good meat, Revolve Hademan. In my country, I was a benevolent dictator until the coup d'etat. So I'm studying Harvard Law until my inevitable return. And you? You can call me Your Majesty.
Please do.
Edith Hoops! I was in the Peace Corps building family clinics out of mud and trees with my bare hands. It was hot and exhausting, and I loved every minute of it. But Harvard Law needs me more, because we need to fight the oppressive, patriarchal...
Oh man. My god, I love your top. So fatigue chic. So, Snaps, how psyched are you guys? Our first day at Harvard Law? Oh, I'm Elwood, and this is Bruiserwitz.
Enid.
Oh my god, we both have names that start with an E.
Oh my god, we're like practically twins.
We're just going around the room. Why don't you tell us something about yourself?
Oh, me? Well, I'm a Gemini with a double Capricorn moon. I have a bachelor's degree from UCLA, where I was Sig Epsilon Sweetheart, president of the Delta Nu sorority, and under the chair shop for a cause.
Huh. I don't think dogs are exactly allowed in class.
Oh, Bruiser's not a dog. Bruiser's family.
Alan?
Oh my god, Warner! I totally forgot you go here!
What are you doing here?
Well, I go here.
You got into Harvard.
What, like it's hard?
I think this is yours. Woods, comma, L?
Oh, is this my social agenda?
No, your academic roster.
Right. There's that. Oh, we should totally catch us.
All that pink you're wearing, is that even legal?
Oh, well, pink's my signature color.
So I gather.
Alright, settle down. Callahan should be here any second. 3 years ago, I was sitting right where you're sitting, and I heard the same rumors I'm sure you've all heard too. Callahan is ruthless. But what you really need to know is that...
Right to remain silent! Join a profession like the law, you're bound to hear the phrase, a lawyer is a shark. Ignore that. It's simplistic, and it's stupid. Only some of you will become sharks. The rest of you are chum. What's my point? I'll tell you. From this class, I will pick 4 young sharks to work at my billion-dollar law firm as interns for me, virtually guaranteeing you a career. Provided you survive. Now, Miss...
Woods, Al Woods.
Somebody's had their morning coffee. Would you please describe and summarize the case of State of Indiana versus Hearn from your reading, please?
Okay. Who was I reading on the first day of class?
You've got guts, Miss Woods. Now, Miss Kensington?
Yes.
If you're a Harvard professor and on the first day of school one of your law students hasn't done the assigned reading, would you let it slide?
No, I'd throw her out.
Hey, Woods, comma L. Listen, I was kicked out of class once first year too, and it's awful, but trust me, your law career's not over.
Law career? So another problem. Listen, I have to get back to the class with Warner.
Then come back tomorrow and make sure you've done your reading.
Okay, thanks. Excuse me, but why would you do that to another girl?
Do what?
We girls have to stick together. We shouldn't try to look good by making each other look bad.
I didn't make you look bad. You just weren't prepared. Why don't you actually try opening a law book? I have to warn you, they don't come with pictures.
If you you ladies a moment, then.
Oh, Warner, thank God you're here.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Sorry about what?
Warner, isn't there something you want to share with Elle?
Do you know her?
Yeah, Elle. Vivian and I went to boarding school together, and she's my girlfriend now.
I'm sorry, I just hallucinated. What did you say?
He said, I'm his girlfriend.
Girlfriend?
Lotto win. Something else is going on here.
Okay. Well, I'm Elle Woods, and I came all the way out here for Harvard Law.
That's a good school.
I know, right? Well, I came out here to follow my one true love, Warner. And now he's preppy! Oh.
So what's she got that you don't got?
Apparently she's serious with a mousy brown bob. Apparently that's what Warner wants, so I need you to make me a brunette.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Do you know what the number one reason for every serious hair mistake is? Love.
You're lost without your love.
Your heart is on the floor. I can help you. I've been there before. When I need to relax, I just turn on some tracks from this CD I bought for the store. Isn't this relaxing? It's called Celtic Moods. See, my mom was 3/4 Italian, and my father I never knew. But my grandfather came from Ireland, the land where dreams come true. He said all Irish men are like heroes. They're descended from poets and kings. So I swore I'd get married in Ireland in a wedding like Lord of the Rings. And my red-headed groom, I can see him as we stroll past the churches and bars. He's a sailor named Brendan. He can dance without moving his arms. In a bar once I met this guy Dewey, and he bought me like 14 beers, and he told me that he was from Ireland. So I lived with him 10 years, and the wedding he kept on postponing. Still I followed him round in a fog, till he dumped me for some girl named Kayla, took my savings and took my dog! My grandfather should have just shut it. Every story he told me steered me wrong. All the dreams that he gave me got gutted. All that's left is this weird and your song. See, a smart girl like you has a future and have hope as each new day dawns. Girls like you always get to see Ireland. Send my love to the
are shut.
We're little sailors.
Beyond adorable. No woman should be denied her dog.
Tell me something I don't know.
So, Whitney, I'll bring the lobster pot stickers.
Oh, and I've got a case of Chardonnay, so that's going to be a real party.
Oh.
There's a party? Oh.
Hello, Al.
Yeah, this Friday night, a few people are going to be together.
Hey, maybe that's why you'd like to be there, Al. You should go.
Oh, yes, definitely come. It's a costume party.
I love costume parties.
Of course you do. 8 o'clock next Friday night, 243 Mass Avenue. Hope to see you there.
Okay, thanks, Vivian.
You should go and do this. Because if a girl like you cannot win back her man, there is no hope for the rest of us.
Thank you for talking me off the ledge, Paulette. You have no idea how bad I need this.
Now you go and you fight for him.
Did you know that Whitney's father is next in line to be Speaker of the House?
So you said.
Just think of it, Warner. There could be future presidents in this very room.
Great.
What do you think about that?
We'll have to see after my,
Whoa!
Hey, stranger!
Elf! Man! What's with the costume?
I can't a girl shake things up?
I still can't get over the fact you're here at Harvard.
Warner, I got into this school same as you. And now that we're both here studying law, maybe we can both get Callahan's internship together.
Whoa, Elf. You don't actually think you have a chance of getting that internship, do you?
Of course.
Hello, Al. You're looking, fluffy as usual.
Hello, Vivian.
Okay. Al? You've got to ace that class to get that internship. It's not called C-minus Callahan for nothing.
Warner, I am completely cognizant of both of those facts.
You're not going to make it to the end of this semester letting alone get into Callahan's internship. Face it, bunny. Someday, we'll be nominating Supreme Court justices while you'll tan.
And thanks for the great tip on the costume party, Vivian. I see that you came as last year's sample sale.
Oh, Elle. What's up, Doc?
Love.
Excuse me?
I put my faith in love. I followed where it led.
Love led you here?
To my personal circle of hell. It has not worked out well. I wish that I were dead. Cause instead of a wagon and love, I'm walking out of school, a total laughing stock. Someone he and his friends can just laugh. So go in here's my head, just hit it with a rock.
Wait, go back. You came out here to follow a man. Harvard Law was just part of that plan. Man, what rich, romantic planet are you from?
Malibu.
Instead of lying outside by the pool, you stalk some guy to an Ivy League school. That's the weirdest reason I...
Well, I do come.
Okay. I grew up in the Roxbury slums with my mom and a series of bums. Guys who showed me all the ways a man can fail. I got through Harvard, I worked like a fool. Worked two jobs in addition to school. So forgive me for not weeping at your tale.
Well, excuse me, just because you have some kind of chip on your shoulder.
You know what? You're right. There's a chip on my shoulder, and it's big as a boulder. With the chance I've been given, I'm gonna be driven as hell. I'm so close I can taste it, so I'm not gonna waste it. Yeah, there's a chip on my shoulder. You might wanna get one as well.
I'm sorry, but that sounds highly negative.
I'm just being honest. When you weren't born into privilege, you gotta work twice as hard. And I want that sweatshirt back.
Wait, two jobs plus law school?
I haven't slept in 6 years.
So I just need to prove to everyone that I'm serious.
What you need is to get to work. What's this, my second, or is this my third? Anyway, I love it! Define malum prohibitum.
Malum prohibitum is...
an act prohibited.
An act prohibited by law, like jaywalking or chewing gum in Singapore.
Therefore, malum in se?
Is an act that's evil in itself. Assault? Murder? Why choose after liberty?
Good. Where are you going?
Oh, home, of course. It's Thanksgiving break, remember?
Interesting.
What?
Well, I predict you will probably pass in the bottom percent of your class.
What?
If you're going for mediocre, you've done great.
That's not fair.
Look, they laughed at me like they're laughing at you. We can't win if we don't follow through. Might I venture your vacation plans can wait?
Why do you always have to be right?
For you. Not quite as good as going home for Christmas, but...
You're too sweet.
It's a time saver. It's a real time saver. It's shampoo and conditioner in one.
Thank you. You're too adorable to think of me.
Hey, have you seen Viv anywhere? We're everywhere.
Yeah. And you know.
Great. We're gonna miss our flight.
Elle? I don't know if you've noticed before, but each time Werner walks through the door, your IQ goes down to 40. Maybe less. Though it's hardly my business to say, could it be the real thing in your way? Is the very guy you're trying to impress?
Yes! I've been smiling and sweet and thoroughly beaten, blowing my chance. Let's not chase him away, let's face him and say, hey, come, let's dance!
Maybe Professor Callahan's not coming today.
This is not one of those classes where we're just getting, we're waiting on him, but we're going to discuss the law. We're going to talk about some cases here.
Maybe he's testing us.
I'm fairly sure.
Quiet in class! Plaintiff ordered a princess party, but she got pirates instead. Breach of contract. There was no meeting of the minds. They don't have to pay. Now you're thinking like a lawyer. Yes, Miss Woods?
Well, Mr. Huntington makes an excellent point. I just have to ask, did the kids actually see the pirates?
The mother shut it down during the opening number. There were peg legs, there were parrots, but not a princess in sight.
Well, contracts could be expressed or implied. Baltimore and Ohio Railroad versus the U.S. 1923. As soon as the pirates started their show, even for a second, the contract was in fact implied. Pirate parties are tragic, but the mother has to pay.
Miss Woods, you just won your case.
Oh my God!
Miss Woods, I assume you're applying for my internship? Do you have a resume?
Yes, I left it on your desk. And thank you in advance for your consideration.
Three months ago, I would have told you to throw that in the trash. Make sure you keep it on file.
Guess she got a chip on her shoulder. Maybe some wise man told her, with the chance we've been given, we've gotta be driven as hell. So close I can taste it. She's so close she can taste it. The first big test that she aced. She's so close she can taste it. She's got a chip on her shoulder. You never can tell.
Are you ready?
I don't know, Al. Dewey scares me.
Okay, so just channel that fear. Tell yourself you are a strong, independent woman and you must be reunited with your daughter.
Get off of my property.
I want to see my dog, Dewey. But you didn't even know today is his birthday.
Well, you can't see him. Best decision I ever made. Throwing you out.
Can you believe I lived with that for 10 years? That cheapskate never even got me a ring.
We lived together for 10 years.
Now what?
Mr. Dewey, I do not think you realize that the greater state of Massachusetts recognizes your relationship with Miss Bonafonte as a common marriage, which therefore entitles her to equitable division of property.
Huh?
Translation, we're taking the dog!
Was that law? Is this the point of law? I'm feeling kind of high.
You good?
Is this why we all study and slog to help the underdog I so identify? I'm so happy for her. When do you think that internship's being posted?
It should be any second. They're
relatively soon about this big decision. Hey guys, Callahan had a big murder trial defending the exercise during Brook Wyndham. He's gonna need extra help. He's posting his internship today.
Ladies and gentlemen, I need the best and the brightest. Congratulations to the choice few. To the rest of you, welcome to the middle. Emmett, I'm making you my co-counsel on this Wyndham trial. Prove yourself here, the name associate isn't far off.
Yes, sir.
Emmett, that's so great, I'm so proud of you.
What?
It's just like we planned.
Babe, this is just the beginning. It's perfect. Will you make me the happiest man I know?
We will.
Marry me.
Yes.
My mind, and at last you'd find you could love me again. And I have turned my whole world upside down, trying not to let you go. Watching you walk away is like a fatal blow. What?
I feel so much better.
was a pound or two. Then you can turn this up right now. My workout's not for you. I'm talking to the woman who wants it all. You gotta pay for what you get. His size too close, don't have to dust, too lazy to sweat. I want you whipped into shape. When I say jump, say how high. You know you're doing it right when you start to cry. If you don't look like you should, you got to keep it, whip it, whip it good. But please no escape till you're whipped into shape. Come on, Dana. What doesn't kill us makes us harder.
We've got a lot to cover. You've got brand new quiet crook. You've hit a laugh with cheese made tons. Offer DVDs and book. Whip your way through tighter buns. Happily married, so she claims, to her 60-year-old stud. Till stepdaughter came downstairs and found Brooke all covered in his blood. Now, show of hands. Who thinks she's guilty? Okay, now. Here is where you kids come in. Brooke has trouble trusting me. I'm her only chance to win, but I don't speak MTV. Though Brooke won't help her own defense, she may listen to her peers. Go and place a little sense in that space between her ears. Not now. I want her whipped into shape. If there's a brain in that hair, tell it that I am the key. It's the plea or the chair. See that when I talk to her, I get neither plea nor plan nor alibi. To quote from our defendant's tape, I want her whipped into shape. To jail!
Does not mean we can't become the best that we can be. I want you whipped into shape. When I say jump, say how high. You know you're doing it right when you start to cry. If you don't look like you should, you got to whip it, whip it, whip it. But prison ladies, no escape till you're whipped into swipe it, swipe it, swipe it through. Check it out!
Wyndham, I'm Emma Forrest, co-counsel with Stidwell, Zaskowski, Fox, and Callahan. These interns are the best of the best at Harvard Law, and we're here to whip up your defense. Incidentally, my mom's a big fan of your DVDs, credits you with her nutcracker butt. Her words. Anyway, we'd like to discuss your case and go over a few choices with you, and we'll see how that goes. Okay, well, let's talk about a few choices. Callahan briefed me on your meeting, and there's a significant amount of evidence against you. So the jury is going to want to hear an alibi.
Not going to happen.
Even though it could save you?
Yeah, put me on the stand and I'd be forced to lie.
Okay, Ms. Wyndham, if we can't hear an alibi, you should accept a plea bargain.
And admit to something I didn't do?
But with a plea bargain, you'd be out in a couple of years. That sounds reasonable, doesn't it?
Reasonable? To do time for my husband's killer? No, not really.
Ooh, she's tough.
Yo, sister!
Yo, not related. Look, I am an event team who actually knows I'm innocent. Get out of here, all of you. Guard!
Who is the girl with loyal friends and true? Who has a bond as strong as crazy glue? Who can sound a call when sisters all come through? Who? Delta Nu Nu Nu. Delta Nu Nu Nu. You are a Delta Nu. Delta Nu Nu Nu. Delta Nu Nu Nu. You are a Delta Nu. Delta Nu's former UCLA president, Al Woods. I knew I recognized your mugshot.
Shut up!
Oh, yeah.
Finally, someone on this defense team actually understands me.
I believe you, Brooke.
and I will fight with everything I have to clear your good name. But that involves an alibi.
I can't tell it.
Everyone has their secrets. For years, I denied my highlights.
This is beyond highlights, Al. It's a disgrace. It's nuclear. And if it got out, it would destroy my entire fitness empire, which means everything to me. If I tell you, do you Delta Nu Sister swear not to tell anyone?
I will double Delta Nu Sister swear.
You're hardcore.
Okay. On the day my husband was killed, I was out getting...
What?
Brooke, you're gonna have to speak up. I can hear you.
Liposuction! Fairly basic outpatient lipo, but lipo!
Oh my god! I know! You have to help me out, you swore!
Your secret's safe with me, I promise.
Thank you, my friends are counting on me. You swore!
Time's up.
Ellie, you gotta help me.
Ellie, there you are.
Oh. Where's Brooke?
The guard just took her back.
Great.
But I got her alibi.
You're kidding. So, what is it?
I'm afraid I can't tell you.
Why not?
Because I double Delta Nu Sister swore not to.
Hell, this isn't some stupid little sorority thing.
Oh, I know. It is a big sorority thing. But trust me, Brooke really had nothing to do with it. Think about it. Brooke's an exercise queen. Exercise gives you endorphins, and endorphins make you happy. But happy people just don't kill.
Kevin, homework.
Al, you can't be serious. If you don't give us this alibi, we're all going to lose this case.
But I guess we're not very good lawyers.
Will you stop being a Maryland Al? Pooh Bear. Al. Callahan wants that alibi. Give it to him, you can sail through law school knowing you've got a big fat job offer waiting for you at the end of it.
But I gave Brooke my word.
So what? Who cares?
Who cares?
Emmett, let me make this very clear. I gave you two simple tasks. Lead this legal team, and find me an alibi. You're 0 for 2. Alright, field trip's over. Come on, let's go. Back to work. Not you two. I'd rather not see Ratty Corduroy and Legally Blonde again today.
Emmett, I'm sorry.
I don't need you to be sorry, Elle. I need you to give me the alibi.
I can't. I gave Brooke my word. There are more ways to win this case than by giving up an alibi.
No, but it sure would help.
Work with me here. We'll free Brooke the right way, the noble way.
This isn't a Lifetime original movie, Elle. I'm not interested in nobility right now. I'm interested in saving Brooke's life.
No, you're not. You're more interested in impressing Callahan.
Well, he is my boss. If I impress him, he'll make me associate.
Client's trust in our integrity?
When you put it that way.
Exactly, butthead. My word means something, right? It does too.
Nobody's called me a butthead since third grade.
Maybe not to your face. Come on, let's get out of here.
Why do you always have to be right?
I don't have to. When I'm with you, I just am.
Even your friend, Emmett?
Well, he is on the team, too.
In more ways than one. I've seen the way he looks at Jeff.
Colette, he's just a friend.
I could use a friend like that.
I've got a package. Paulette Bonafonte. The name's Kyle. This is my new route and the first stop of the day. Pretty cool karma, huh? Already. Do me a favor. Have yourself a super day.
Oh my God. The new UPS guy is like a walking god.
Well, talk to him already.
Right. I'm not like you.
I can't talk to guys like that. I've got nothing to offer.
Oh my God.
Did you see that?
She has the most amazing bend and snap I've ever seen.
What are you talking about? Bend and snap.
The bend and snap. It was a move invented by the UCLA cheerleaders to break the will of the opposing team.
For real. You must become the cheerleader you fear.
You've got the pom-poms. It's time to shake them. Ready? Okay.
Look at my abs, look at my thighs. I'm catnip to the guys. They chase my tail, they drool and pant. Want to touch this, but they can't. Go!
Get it.
Every trial has its surprises. I didn't expect the biggest surprise of all to be how impressed I am with you. You're stubborn, but all good lawyers are. You turned out to be a great leader.
Thank you, Professor Callahan. You have no idea what that means to me. And thank you again for this internship. I've learned so much already.
It's not about what you've learned. You've got instincts, and instincts, legal or otherwise, can't be taught. Trust your instincts.
Is that the only reason you gave me this internship?
I thought you were smarter than that. It's been nice working with you, Miss Woods.
Take back the books and pack up the clothes. Clear out the room and drop off the key. Leave with what's left of my dignity. Get in the car. Just go. Chalk it all up to experience. They said I'd fail, but I disagreed. Who could say then where my path would lead? Well, now I know. Back to the sun, back to the shore, back to what I was before. Back where I'm known, back in my own very small pond. Laugh with my friends when I arrive. We'll drop the top and just drive. That's fine with me. Just let me be legally blonde.
Hey, there she is.
Callahan, hail me.
What?
He tried to kiss me. He fired me. He made it very clear I don't belong.
He's wrong. We'll fix it. We'll fight
and it. Please. There's no reason for me to stay.
What about love? I've never mentioned love. The timing's bad, I know. But perhaps if I made it more clear that you belong right here, you wouldn't have to go. Cause you know that I'm so much in love.
Back to the sun, back to the shore, back to what I was before. High on the beach, drink within reach. Don't strip me out.
We both know you're much in love.
Some girls my heart, some face the trial. Some girls are just meant to smile.
Is it late? Can I just say I want you to stay?
It's not up to me. Just let me be legally blonde.
Stay.
It's not up to me. Just let me be legally blonde.
Duty calls.
that, and he has a job. I go get Rufus's manicure.
Paulette, I just came to say goodbye.
Goodbye? What?
I'm going back to California.
Why?
I'm going back to where I make sense.
You're not making any right now. Honey, what happened?
All this time I thought I was proving myself. But it turns out I'm just one big blonde joke, and that's all anyone's ever gonna see. Vivian?
We girls need to stick together.
Thank you.
represent you?
Actually, she can, Your Honor. Rule 303 of the Supreme Judicial Court states that a law student, Miss L. Woods, may represent a defendant in criminal proceedings.
That's only if she has a licensed attorney supervising. Without me, she doesn't have that.
I'm licensed, Your Honor, and I will gladly supervise her.
Why, hell you will! You work for me, remember?
No, I don't. I work for myself. And I don't have to hit on interns, Professor.
Enjoy prison, Miss Windham.
Okay, bye.
Thank you, Emmett.
Did you think I was actually gonna let you just get away?
Miss Woods, any day now, you may proceed. Call your first witness.
We call Chubby Windham to the stand.
Oh my god! TGP! Tragic curve. Ew.
Miss Windham, what was your relationship to the deceased?
He was my father.
And did you actually see his murder take place?
No, I was out.
Doing what?
I was getting a perm.
Interesting. And did you see anyone suspicious hanging around your house?
Suspiciously hanging around my shower?
No, before that.
No, I was out getting the perm.
And then you went home and took a shower?
Yeah, I took a shower.
Interesting. My associate has just gotten a perm herself today. Exhibit A, Miss Enid Hoops. Thank you, Miss Bonafonte. Now, Miss Windham, would Exhibit A's perm be similar to your own?
Duh.
And so now, once again, you did not see the murder take place or hear the gunshot because you were where?
In the shower.
Thank you. Miss Hoops, would you kindly step into the shower?
Idiot. You can't get a perm wet for 48 hours.
Exactly. The water deactivates the perm's ammonium thioglycolate and completely ruins it. It's the cardinal rule of perm maintenance. Your perm is still intact, so you couldn't have showered that day. Why would you lie about being in the shower?
I was...
Why would you lie about hearing the gunshot?
But I...
Why would you lie about any of it?
You think I liked being older than my father's new arm candy wife? I didn't mean to hurt him. I didn't mean to shoot him. I thought it was you coming out of that door.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Hold on. Enough that I'm in a jump. And we apologize.
Take you seriously. I was wrong.
Thank you, Warner.
We do belong together. You've shown me what we can be together again.
Oh, Warner. Vivian dumped you, didn't she? Though I dreamed of this day long ago. Now my answer is thank you, but no. Look, it's barely begun, I'm hardly through. I was living in ignorant bliss, till I learned I could be more than this. And you know, in a way, I owe it all to you. I thought losing your love was a blow I could never withstand. Look how far I have come without anyone holding my hand. Me the chance to make a brand new start.
once wrote, "To thine own self be true." And as so follows the night, must the day. Thou can't be false to any man. I believe this wise statement best applies to a woman, a blonde woman. For these past 3 years, she's taught me and shown all of us that being true to yourself never goes out of style. Ladies and gentlemen, our valedictorian, Miss L. Woods. I thank you one and all, the ones who thought I'd fall. You taught me how to fail, who helped me to prevail.